hopefully you'll enjoy what's coming up here. I'm doing a quick tutorial for you. I was just wanting to do something that was pretty simple, and my main focus for this piece was to do a really highly detailed focal point, which is going to be the character's face, and that everything else would just blur into the image. I have a tendency to get over detailed on every piece, on every part of a piece, so sometimes I'll do this to practice to get away from that. So what you'll be seeing me doing as I go is one of the things, techniques that I really like to do is to try not to stay zoomed into an image for too long. If you zoom out of an image, then you can see the overall image and how it's working together. Whereas if you're always zoomed really close in, then you can kind of get lost in what you're seeing. As you'll see, I do zoom in somewhat when I'm doing eyes or mouth, that kind of thing. But overall, every once in a while, I try to zoom back out. And the other thing that I really like to do, which I suggest is what you're seeing here, is I flip the image. Actually, that's a hotkey, Control Y, and it really helps. Again, it's a mind thing. You look at an image for so long in some certain way that you get used to that, and you may not see some of the mistakes that you'd notice if you move the image around. So I'll often hit Control Y and it'll flip the image. And what you're seeing here is I'm messing with the face. This was, you know, I knew it was going to be a tutorial. I was just kind of on a whim doing this one, so I didn't have a lot of pre-thought into this. However, normally what I'll do is I will sketch out an image and then scan it into Photoshop and start painting that way. And that really helps because it helps the process go a little faster, because you already have a real set idea on what you want to do. And here I'm kind of bringing in some lines to kind of get an idea of exactly where I want everything to go. When I do lines or a hard line, I use a hard brush, and that's usually good because it can, like right there as you see, because it can just get that really defined look that you want. When I'm doing blending, I use a very soft brush, and brushes are really great to make, to just have a good variety of brushes. And a lot of the brushes that I get, I'll get from friends or whatnot, but a really great place that you can actually go to is the ImagineFX magazine. It's amazing. You can get it at Barnes Noble. It's like $15, I think. It's a British issued magazine, so that's why it's kind of more expensive for us in the US. So, but I would definitely suggest checking it out. It comes with a CD that has tutorials on it as well, from some great artists, BioFam, Marta DeLigue, just a couple of the people that I love, and they have a lot of good tutorials. And but the one thing that I love to get is brushes from the ImagineFX CD. But the magazine itself is great as well. You get a lot of information on how to do things. So here what I'm doing is I'm adding some of the highlights. As you saw, I kind of build from the base up. So I start with, you know, a mid-tone, then I add some shadows and darker tones, and then I add the light at the end. And we're just doing some rim lights here and getting the nose to be the right shape. And as you're seeing here, I do zoom in quite a bit, but as you see, like, I'm zooming out and then zooming back in. I want to make sure to get all the details right, but I'll zoom back out so that I can make sure that, you know, I'm not getting too focused on an area to where I'm basically messing up. So, yeah, in this image, I know her face is going to be our focal point, so I want to make sure that there's quite a bit of detail on there and spend the most time on the face. And any image that you do or illustration, you know, you want to have that idea of having a focal point and to be able to guide your eye from focal point to focal point, because you can have more than one, but you want to make sure that that gets the most detail and the most love out of the rest of the image. we're just highlighting the lips to give a little bit more of a gloss look. And this image, it's monochromatic in like a blue, navy blue, almost greenish colors. And sometimes, you know, it's fun to do because it simplifies things when you have it monochromatic, when you just have it as one color as your main color that you use. But normally it's really good to have more than one, like doing, you know, doing like complementary colors and whatnot. But even with monochromatic, even though I'm basically using, staying within kind of a color range, I do have, there's pinks in there, there's, you know, more warmer colors within her face and whatnot, but it's kind of staying all on the cool side of things towards more of the blue. And later on you'll see that I'll add in some lights or some rim lights to kind of complement the image and the color. Here with the eyelashes, normally I don't like to put just lines for the upper eyelashes. I like to make them in kind of in blocks, unless, like, it depends on the image, but for this one I felt like doing just kind of solid shape for the upper eyelashes, you know, were the best way to do it, just to get that feel. And actually one of my favorite comic book artists, Michael Turner, I watched a couple of his tutorials, and he did that a long time ago, before he passed away, and I think that's something that already always stuck with me. But as you see, as the bottom eyelashes, I do more of a single type strokes. So just adding the shadows here on the eyes, and that gives a little bit more shape for the eye. And yeah, just filling in shape, and now we're doing the eyebrows. One thing with the eyebrows that I thought works pretty well, and it's pretty simple, and I was really glad when I figured it out, is if you eyedrop, which is just Alt, and then click when you're like on a brush, or if you're on the paint bucket tool, you eyedrop on the skin, and then you brush that into the eyebrows, and it actually kind of gives more of that look of an eyebrow. And what you saw me there doing a little bit ago, I was getting started to add some rim lighting, but I decided to do some more of the rest of the picture first. And I'm just outlining different pieces kind of to fill it in from just the original sketch that I had done. And again, I'm still trying to not have too much detail below her face, but, you know, I want to try to make it somewhat believable. I was trying to keep with more a painterly look, so kind of like haphazardly, you know, painting along, but I still wanted to get some sort of definition in there so you can really tell that, like, it's her arms and whatnot. So here I'm adding some rim lighting, and what this does is it really helps an image, to, especially a monochromatic image, it makes it pop and brings up some variety in the color. Now I had it on a separate layer, and I have it invisible now because sometimes when you have a gradient overlaid or, you know, on top, and then you start eyedropping and whatnot, it can actually ruin, like, it can I drop the color you're seeing, but it won't work for if it's a lower level or a lower layer than where the eyedropper gradient was. And here I'm just doing some of the hair. Again, I start from a base color and work my way up. And I usually use, for monochromatic, I used about 3 or 4 different tones and whatnot. But for if I was doing lots of more colors, complementary colors, then there'd be much more in the hair, but I wanted to keep it pretty simple for this one. And as now, before I get into it on the image, what I wanted to do is after this, like I said, I wanted to keep it almost painterly like and more natural like than just a digital painting. So what I'm going to be doing in a second, you'll see it, getting a paper texture and then overlay it on the image. And what you're going to see, let's see, there we go, getting the texture. And what I do is I go in the highlighted area that you saw and under, and I just chose, I normally go with multiply or overlay, but as you're seeing, I mess with the levels, which is Control L, and variations. I'm actually planning to do another tutorial on hotkeys, because I think hotkeys are the shit. So those just are amazing. So I'm going to do another tutorial on that separately, but just messing with the levels and to get a better, you know, look of the image and get a little bit more of like a rustic kind of look. And we're almost done. And just putting my signature, final touches. And there we go. Have the final image. Hope you guys liked that. And remember to like, comment, subscribe. On the comments, please write if you liked it, you didn't like it, whatever. If you have any suggestions, you need help with anything, please comment on my channel and I'd be happy to go ahead and do a tutorial for you. So thanks again, guys, and enjoy, friends.